Hello once again, guys. Buzz Killington here, and another two-week character unlock event is upon us. The Winged Prime is the next Tyranid that we can collect, along with, of course, the Neurothrope, the Tyrant Guard, and the recently announced Death Leaper, available exclusively through your Battle Pass now. So yeah, we will be familiar with the Winged Prime through the Screamer Killer Guild Raid boss, so I won't go into huge detail, but it's worth having a quick chat about the guy, how tough he can be, going over his skills. So, something that is worth noticing is that he does not obviously, the way the Prime had a particular weakness for the Silent Killer, Screamer Killer, to Flame and Blast, he doesn't have that problem. He is a lethal killing machine. And he can zip about the battlefield like nobody's business. So he's a Tyranid, he is a synapse creature. God, excuse me. So friendly units within 2 hexes may behave as normal. They ignore any instinctive behavior trait. They also ignore battle fatigue. That is going to be important for you. He is a flyer. Can traverse, no problem. Extremely maneuverable, but doesn't get the cover bonus. And he has Final Vengeance. Nice little trait to have, of course. Normal attack on an eligible target unless overkilled. So you think you got him down, but he's just going to spite you just that little bit more as the hive mind compels him to just try and basically slash you to bits. I love the animation for him. The look of the character is really cool. Look at this guy. It is a really, really great look. I mean, you've seen him on the battlefield, you've seen how he moves, you've seen how he looks. I love the artwork for all the Tyranids, and this guy is no exception. But yeah, on to his stats as usual. Epic. I've got him to Epic, I've got him to level 35, Gold 1. This is where I usually like to showcase them at and see just how tough they can be. But what I might also do is bump him up to Diamond 1 maybe, see how he looks there. But for now, at this particular level, 2,746 health. So he's a bit, he's going to stick around. 550 armor, not the best, but he's got a little bit of staying power there. He's obviously not as tanky as some other characters. But if we skip to, like, obviously the Tyrant Guard only has 100 odd more baseline armor. Tyrant Guard can, of course, take more defensive items intended to augment his armor skills. But the Winged Prime can boost his armor a little bit as well. So he is tougher than he looks. He combines that with his maneuverability. Speed 4. So this guy is great. And it's already, the fact he has speed 4 gives you some ideas of exactly how you're going to be using him. And I'll go into some detail about my thoughts on that in just a second. So bio attacks. 30% pierce ratio. Not the best. But he makes up for that by having 6 of them. 6 hits. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I can't count if he was doing 6 hits there. But yeah, 6 bio hits. And each one at the moment at level 35, 293 per hit. So you're looking at nearly 1,800. You're looking at 1,758 damage in total from the 6 hits. Before armor is obviously taken into account. So he does hit pretty damn hard. Lightly armored targets are going to be in a lot of trouble against him, like Thaddeus Noble. Thaddeus Noble is not going to be safe from this guy. There are plenty of characters who like to hang around at the back making nuisances of themselves. Morgan Ra, for instance, Calandis even. This guy can hunt them down and take them out. So yeah, that's a good use for him already. No range, but of course he doesn't really need it. He is the range. But let's look at his particular abilities. I am going to go passive first this time. Synaptic Linchpin. So the key fun thing about this guy is that he is your summoner. I mean, we don't know what the legendary Tyranid is going to be or what that particular character can do. But for the moment, this is your summoner. So it's very key. It's very interesting, actually. Whenever the Winged Tyranid Prime key again, or another friendly unit with synapse, performs a normal attack against an enemy and that enemy survives, summon a Hormagaunt adjacent to the target, which it immediately attacks. Cannot have more than 3 summoned this way at the same time. When you get him to legendary, it goes up to 4. I haven't yet looked. I might push him to 50 and then just see. I'll show you that at the end, I think. Yeah, I've decided I'm going to do that now. So, yeah, we have up to 3 Hormigaunts on a battlefield. So there is an argument. You want to get him across the battlefield. You want him to attack a target that you know he's not going to kill, at least in round 1. So because that will get you an immediate Hormigaunt summon. Bear in mind as well, the Neurothrope also has Synapse. So get the Neurothrope out. Get the Neurothrope to launch an attack. If the Neurothrope's target also survives, another Hormigaunt. It doesn't have to be the Winged Tyranid Prime doing the attack. The Neurothrope will work as well. And again, maybe the Legendary Tyranid when we know if they have Synapse or not. So obviously the Tyrant Guard won't do it. He does not have Synapse. The Lictor won't do it. The Death Leaper will not do it. But there are 2 options there. And in fact, smart people will have already worked out that in fact there are 3 options. But I'll tell you that in a second. So again, look at the Hormigaunt stats. 1197 health, 200 armor, 714 physical damage. Pretty irritating characters, basically. Just enough to be annoying. They'll tie your enemy up. They'll inhibit them. Particularly if you're facing someone like units like Tau, you really want to inhibit their close combat, kicking that close combat modifier. So even at range, you could do that. You could inflict the damage there and get that summons out. But yeah, let's go and look at the active. Alpha Warrior. If the Winged Prime has not moved this turn, summon a Tyranid Warrior in a free hex within Synapse range. The Tyranid Warrior has the Synapse trait and immediately performs a normal attack against the nearest enemy. So bear that in mind. Firstly, we're getting a Tyranid out. He can do physical damage, he can do range damage, 856 of each one, pretty good. 30% pierce ratio, obviously pitiful physical damage, but look at that health. That health, he is beefy, man. He has got only 500 less health than the Winged Prime. You're getting a Tyranid Warrior out, good armor as well, decent damage. This guy is not to be messed with. So bear in mind as well, as the Tyranid Warrior has the Synapse trait, that makes him the 3rd character. So of course, if the Tyranid Warrior performs a normal attack against an enemy and that enemy survives, then you get a Hormigaunt. So play the active against an appropriate character, as an armored character, and you can get a Tyranid Warrior summon and a Hormigaunt summon in the same turn. And that is even before the Neurothrope has floated forward to do a normal attack. Maybe on a different character completely, there's another Hormigaunt out. That's 3 summons out in 1 turn. And they are beefy summons. The Alpha Warrior, the Tyranid Warrior, is going to be a big problem for your enemy. And that trait really makes... Obviously, the Winged Prime can't move. So, I mean, depending if they floated in on Overwatch or something. If the enemy's on Overwatch, you don't want to engage with them right that moment. If you could suppress them with the Lictor, maybe. Then the Winged Prime does his active, gets a Tyranid Warrior in there, and you just start to build a swarm up and just dismantle the enemy. Or just even if you don't fancy the positioning, you just want to get that Tyranid Warrior out straight away, try and slow the enemy down. There's real potential there. He has to obviously sit still for a turn. But also, again, consider this. If you pair him with Aun Shi on your team, mixed team obviously, then there's real potential for havoc here. Have Aun Shi nearby, recharge is active straight away. 2 turns in a row, you're producing Tyranid Warriors and Hormigaunts. That is a nasty tactic. So of course, I really love the sound of it. Yeah. But yes, there you go. That's how this guy is intended to be played. He's maneuverable. He is intended to get in the enemy's face immediately. If depending on how the tactics, how the battlefield looks, get in the enemy's face, start getting the summons off, or clap, get a Tyranid Warrior out. He's going to make a nuisance. He is the one to tie the enemy up with summons, get them distracted, get them trying to hunt this guy down while you get your Neurothrope and your Tyrant Guard in position to start laying absolute pain down on the enemy. So I just love this. He synergizes really well with the other characters. And look at him. I just love the Tyranids. I don't mind admitting it. I love the Tyranids. All right. So I'm going to now take him up to level 50, Diamond 1. I think I'm going to do this with all my future character showcases, just to see just how hardcore they actually end up being. It'll be obviously a long time for anyone to get there. But, you know, why the hell not? Let's just see what they look like. Diamond 1 is not unattainable. I'm nearly there with my Morgan Ra at the moment. I might even have reached it by the time this video goes up. We shall see. But in the meantime, let's check out Diamond 1 and level 50 Winged Prime in just about now. Alright, so here he is. I took him to level 50 Diamond 1 just to see how strong he is, and let's have a look. At Diamond 1, he has 5,300 health. He are looking at 576 damage per hit. That is 3,500 something. I've got some maths I can't do right now. 1,040 armor. He's a beast at Diamond 1. He is a beast. I just left him at Legendary 3, so of course at Legendary 4, potentially he's going to be even stronger Legendary 5. But yeah, this is a good insight into how tough he's going to be. I didn't have the Legendary gear to give him right now, so don't worry about that. But let's look at his abilities. Max level. Hormagaunts have 4,000 health, 2,500 physical damage. Jesus. And a Tyranid Warrior, 3,000 physical and bio damage, nearly 8,000 health. That's insane. So like, obviously it takes so much resources to get a character to level 50. I mean, to even get to Diamond 1, you need to have your guy up to level 44, and that cleans you out of the codexes, obviously, as I painfully am aware. But yeah, at this level, damn man, he is strong. He is really, really strong. As I say, I like this character. Obviously, I'm going to be unlocking him. I'm going to be working hard to level him like I am with all my nids. I want to get this guy to epic minimum, just to see how well it goes. I'm very, very much looking forward to this opportunity to get this character. I love all characters pretty much, except for Pastillion and Darkstrider and Incisus maybe. But yeah, this guy's cool. Let me know what you think of him in the comments. Obviously, he looks pretty damn imposing. Do you agree? Do you think he's going to be a part of your team? Do you think he is not as good as I am cracking him up to be? As ever, let me know what you think. I do value your input. And as ever, thank you very much for watching. Consider checking out my other content if you haven't already. I've got plenty of guides to players and character showcases available as well. All right, until next time, thanks for watching.